I want you to imagine flipping through your high school yearbook and realizing that you were photoshopped out of it. Not forgotten, not missed by accident, literally deleted intentionally. That actually happened to me. In that moment, I didn't feel different. I felt invisible. But being different isn't what held me back. It's what launched me forward. Because being neurodivergent isn't my weakness. It's my superpower. Growing up, I've always been curious. Since I was a kid, I've been obsessed with flight. Kites, planes, rockets. I'd stare at the night sky for hours. But not only did I just want to fly and become an astronaut, I wanted to understand why things flew. My dad's a physics professor, and so instead of bedtime stories, I got physics explanations in Bernoulli's principle. Not great for sleep, but awesome for building backyard rockets. And my mom's job took us around the world, from North Carolina to India, China, South Africa, Thailand, Australia, and beyond. I learned early that everyone sees the world differently. I just didn't realize how differently I saw it too. But socially, I struggled. Making friends didn't come naturally. Small talk felt like speaking a different language. I got bullied a lot, like my yearbook, for being different, for being off, or for being too into space. So I had a plan. What if I could learn enough hobbies and skills so I could find one thing in common, at least, with everyone I met, so I can make connections with people of similar interests and make friends? Origami, art, magic tricks, coding, scuba diving, instruments, music, sports, and crazy things like skydiving, you named it. I learned it. Not to impress people, but to connect on a deeper level. See, I figured if I can connect on something, I wouldn't have to fake anything. Growing up, I didn't have the vocabulary for autism. I even struggled to speak and had a speech therapist to help me speak. Growing up on the spectrum also meant being misunderstood. But over time, I realized that the very things people told me were weaknesses, hyperfocus, sensitivity to detail, obsessive creativity, were actually my greatest strengths. While others saw obstacles, I started seeing opportunity. This isn't just about autism. Neurodivergence can include anyone whose brain is wired differently, like those with ADHD, ADD, OCD, and other neuroatypical conditions. We all share that same unique lens. But during middle school came an aha moment for me, when I stopped trying to erase my identity to change myself to become the person I thought others wanted me to be to make more friends. Instead, I chose to embrace my differences and I started leveraging them. At 10, I started my first business, mowing lawns. At 16, I earned my commercial drone pilot's license and started my aerial photography company. In college, I grew that company, Airmage Media Productions, which was once started in my bedroom, is now a worldwide multimedia production company and has been privileged to help provide creative marketing solutions with companies like Amazon, Marriott, Toyota, and others around the world. And those skills, that hyper-focus, they helped me land internships around the country, such as at SpaceX, where I worked to engineer satellites for the Starlink network, helping to bring the internet to over 70 countries. Not bad for a kid who couldn't hold a conversation at lunch. So what changed? I became me. Embracing who I am in my own skin and letting my true personality flourish. I stopped seeing neurodivergence as something to overcome and started seeing it as the reason I was thriving. I can't, sometimes I can't even, I get lost. My mind is so flustered that I sometimes can't see things very clearly. It gets very overwhelming. But over time, I learned to tune out the noise. And let me share a little story of what that can feel like to be on the spectrum. Imagine you're at a park. The birds are chirping, trains roaming in the distance, and the ice cream man is playing his tune. Now imagine all of that noise at the same volume as the baby screaming across the way and your friend speaking right in front of you. That's what it can feel like to have a neurodivergent brain and be on the spectrum. Everything's demanding attention at once. It's overwhelming. But over time, I learned to tune the noise, choosing what to choose and focus on and turn up, and what to turn down and let go. And sometimes how to communicate through the chaos. That's something I've had to work at my whole life. But that's also why I'm standing here with you today. Because in learning how to overcome those challenges, I've developed communication skills that others don't always have the opportunity to cultivate. We often frame neurodivergence, and specifically being in the autism spectrum, as a deficit, a disorder. Being autistic somehow became a disability. But today, we are flipping that script. What if it's a design feature and not just a bug? Our society often designs systems assuming everyone learns and thinks the same way. But innovation doesn't happen by thinking like everyone else. It happens when someone sees what no one else sees. Think about it. The greatest innovators in history didn't succeed by fitting in. They saw the world differently. The same goes for so many of us in the autistic community who are in the shadows. We may not all show it the same way, but we feel deeply, think deeply, and create deeply. So here's where you, including the non-neurodivergent, can relate. The lessons I've learned from being neurodivergent are not just for those on the spectrum or those just with ADHD or ADD. They are lessons for everyone. Think about some of the struggles you're facing, whether it's stress at work, struggling through school, childhood trauma, managing your family, balancing relationships, or just trying to find your place in the world. Being neurodivergent taught me to see those challenges as opportunities to innovate, to break things down and approach them in a new way. We all have obstacles, but what if, like me, you learn to embrace those struggles as your superpower? What if you were able to find creative solutions like that others might not see? Neurodiversity is not a problem to be solved. It's a perspective to be embraced. The power of small is in tiny choices. Learning one hobby, focusing on one detail. For me, that turned my neurodivergence into my superpower. And that's what neurodivergence offers, a different lens. And that lens can change the world if we let it. So remember that yearbook photo I mentioned? For the longest time, I let that one moment define me, as if being excluded meant I didn't matter. But now, I see it differently, because it pushed me to write myself back onto that page on my own terms. I filled it with my story, my passions, my purpose. Since then, I've started companies, mentored other entrepreneurs, and I'm pursuing a PhD in aerospace engineering using that childhood hobby of origami I taught myself in my bedroom and its physics principles to help hold multi-million dollar spacecraft into rockets to help launch them into space. And soon, I'll be applying to NASA's astronaut program to help bring my research and dreams to life. All because I finally gave myself permission to stop fitting in and start standing out. So here's my message to anyone who's ever been told they're too different, to anyone who's ever felt off, out of place, or misunderstood. You don't need to fit in to belong. You don't need to change to contribute. You definitely don't need to hide your superpower. Embrace your differences, neurodivergent or not. Next time you feel too different, lean into one of your unique strengths. Share it with someone today. That's how you make your superpower soar. I fill my yearbook page with my story. Now embrace your superpower and write your own page. Let's stop asking neurodivergent people to be less of who they are. Let's create a world where their brilliance can take flight. Remember, obstacles don't define your altitude. How you use them does. Because I promise you, when you stop seeing obstacles and start seeing superpowers, the sky isn't the limit. It's just the beginning. Thank you.